Hey guys, in this video we're going to look at four completely free chorus VST plugins you can use on your projects. These plugins are used to add more depth to your recordings by making it sound like there are more of the same instrument playing at once. We'll go through each of these plugins, taking a look at their sound quality as well as all the controls to adjust these effects. Before we start, I've linked to the download page for every chorus plugin used in this video down in the video description, so check that out. To make a fair comparison between all the plugins, I'm using the same electric piano track. Let's take a listen to that first. The first chorus plugin is called Multiply. On the left, we have our dry and wet signal levels to get the balance of chorus sound that we want. Below that, there's the controls for the speed and amount of frequency modulation, which is the difference in frequency between the main signal and the chorus voices, and to the right we can control the amplitude of those voices. Next we have a control for the number of voices. Adding more here will cause a richer chorus sound. Then there's a stereo spread, so we can have the track fully in stereo or bring it down to mono. Next is the pre-delay, which determines how long it takes for the wet signal to come in after the dry. Finally, we just have a simple equalizer at the top, but it does need to be enabled with the top button. One of my problems with this plugin is there's some weird noise at the beginning of every note that can be a little distracting and irritating once you notice it. It kind of sounds like there's too fast of an attack, and the plugin is making that a lot more noticeable. Next up is Blue Cat's Chorus. On the left, we have a simple input gain. Next to that are the controls for the modulation. First is the amount of delay applied. Next is the depth, which is how much variation in the amount of delay there is. Increasing the delay in depth can cause a larger sound, but if done too much, it will start to cause an echo and it also sounds out of tune. Then we have the rate of the modulation, and you'll be able to hear these variations in the chorus speed as we increase this. The spread controls how much it spreads out in stereo. After that, we have a wet and dry mix level. The triangle shape sounds a little more aggressive as the modulation goes back and forth, and the sine is a little bit of a smoother chorus. The next chorus is the Classic Chorus plugin. The first controls the delay time, which has a range and fine control. Then we have the rate and depth of the modulation, like the other plugins. The spread button changes it from stereo to mono. The mix knob adjusts the balance between the direct signal and the process chorus effect. The last control is for gain, so we can match the level with the signal that came in. The last chorus plugin on our list is the Tao Chorus LX plugin. This is based on the Roland Juno 60 chorus. This is a great subtle chorus and it's very simple to use. The first control is just the volume. Then we have our dry, wet, and mixed level. This plugin allows us to select between two different chorus sounds, or we can have them both on. Finally, we can adjust the stereo width, just like the others. Thanks for checking out this video on free chorus plugins to use in your mix. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. Also, you can take a look at our social media links in the video description for another way to check out our new content.